All right. Yeah, so I think I know what I have to do. Let's see if I'm right. I think we have to take this back downstairs. Pull it into that one room on the water so it's floating. Climb on top of it and then shoot the thing. I think that's what we have to do. Yeah, no worries, Max. I know you might be in and out because you're probably going to be trying to get some stuff done while you're... There we go. Wait, how the fuck did I get over there again?
Ugh, water in my boots.
I jumped from up here, didn't I? Why can I not remember how we got in there? Anybody remember how we got in there? Oh, was it this way? I don't think I can get back out of here. Oh, wait. It was through here, wasn't it? I'm just not thinking. Yeah, it was over here. I'm overthinking it again! Oh, come on. Bullshit. Bullshit.
Key module. Good.
There you go.
I think I have everything I need to open the door to the relic.
Through here somewhere. This place is a fucking maze.
Okay, now for the code. Stemmer will be interested in this.
Hooray!
I should give it to him the next time I see him.
Alright. Okay, what else do we have? See, now that's marked as completed, but it's not green. What the fuck? I'm gonna go there first. It's almost like the more I complete, the less it actually marks correctly. I'm gonna take a picture of this lobster. Lobster! I will let that lobster live. There should be a blue lobster. That'd be cool. I wanted to get a picture of the pelicans, but they were glowing because I scanned. Sun. So pretty. Okay, so we're gonna go see if more people talk to me now that the CEO's dead. Mox, you're gonna fucking love how he died.
Don't start.
We can find our way back home like this.
I promise you, we'll find a way home.
Harriam, we're never getting that gyro compass back. We're stuck here. For good.
The ancestor reborn.
May we be led to truth.
Just, Aloy, what's this I hear about you never going back home?
Our navigational ships.
They're all gone. Destroyed by storms and reefs. And with them, the one instrument we need to guide us across the ocean.
There is one ship that might still hold a working gyro compass.
But it's beyond our reach, beached on an island surrounded by deadly currents. No compass, no way home, no way back to those we should have never left behind in the first place.
Christia.
You mentioned you left someone behind?
My, wife, Neandra. She works the field in the Great Delta. When I was chosen for this mission, she begged me not to come. She was scared I wouldn't return. And like always, she was right. I left without saying goodbye, and now I won't ever see her again.
So you two are soldiers?
Navigators. I'm Harriam, and this is Christia.
So, you two know how to use this instrument?
The gyro compass. Only I know how to read it. The diviners trained me. Harriam was chosen to memorize the charts found in the legacy.
So you can't navigate the fleet without each other?
It is the Quen way. The greater the knowledge held by one person alone, the greater the risk it'll be used against the Empire, should we be captured by our enemies.
Your tribe sure is cautious. So you two are soldiers?
Oh wait, and navigators.
So
the gyro compass.
So you can't. It is the Quen. The greater the knowledge, the greater the risk it'll be you.
Your tribe sure. So what is this gyro compass you're looking for?
It's a device used by the ancestors to help pinpoint a ship's location. But it only works if the readings are compared to a chart.
How'd you get your hands on something like that?
I guess it's safe to tell you, since you carry the gift of the ancestors. The diviners found them on ancient vessels back in our homeland, and modified them so we could use them on our ships. Without them, we're at the mercy of the seas.
You said what you need is on a ship somewhere.
Yes. The ship we were stationed on. The night we approached landfall, a sudden squall hit the fleet. While some ships managed to find safe harbor here, ours ran aground. The crew abandoned ship, hoping the ocean would spare us.
I thought we'd drown for sure. Thank the ancestors, we somehow got washed up on a beach southwest of here. Scouts found us and brought us to landfall. Not that it matters. The only ship with a gyro compass is grounded and surrounded by deadly currents.
Okay.
Maybe I can help.
How are we? Unless you can fly.
I can't do that. But if I find a way...
Okay, yeah, so we have to come back here after.
She's an ancestor reborn. Maybe she really can help.
I will not let myself hope just yet, but I thank you for your kindness.
It's finally changed.
Ancestor, please. It's about my brother. I don't mean to disturb you, but I've run my requests through every channel and I've gotten nowhere.
Just take me through it.
Apologies. My name is Jomar. I'm the weapons officer for this expedition. It's my job to ensure the troops are armed and prepared for what's out there. And I've failed to do so. My younger brother, Oris, his unit was sent to scout the tower on the northern side of the island. They should have returned by now. The Overseer has denied my request for a search party, and defying him would mean dismissal, or worse.
You think they might be alive?
Oris has been obsessed with San Francisco ever since I can remember. He jumped at the chance to join this expedition. I have to believe that fate isn't cruel enough to make this place his tomb. If you help me, I'll get you access to any weapon in my stock.
If I make my way up north, I'll look for your brother.
Thank you. If it helps, my brother carried an ancestral relic with him. I believe your focus might be able to pick it up.
What kind of relic?
A small metal piece dangling from a chain, with a hologram of San Francisco. Which is why my brother always had it with him. The diviners speculated it was some kind of beacon, inviting the ancestors to visit the city.
Speculated? So there was data on it they couldn't read?
It was deemed lost knowledge. If my brother truly is... gone. Could you maybe bring the relic back for me? It meant so much to Oris. I'd like to keep it safe. For him.
Of course.
Okay. Alright. Let's see. I'm gonna go do this first. We'll do the quest after we can fly.
I should focus on the task at hand.
Perhaps. They fight with abandon. Something in their eyes.
Okay. Mostly, I want to get the black box and check out all these question marks. And then we'll do the... Because let me see... Collectibles. Because I actually might How many of those am I even missing? So I'm only missing two drones. And four black boxes and two Vista points. And I've got all the ornaments. We just have to go back to
Hope you got more of a fight in you today.
You holding up? Sure.
Where's my Oh, I have this. Oh. I think this is a fire raptor. Crabs.
It must be the tower Jomar mentioned. And it's full of sunwings. That can't be good.
Oh, that one there. I was like, what tower? Whoops. Lobsters galore! Nope, I missed that one. I didn't realize it was behind the thing. This, like, the underwater stuff in this is just so fucking cool. Okay, here's a question. How many people in chat are aware that these sponges here are actually animals and not plants? Because they are.
I should have some of the sweat.
You can't remember if you knew that before or not. Have anything important? I don't think so at this point. But yes, they are in fact animals and not plants like one might think. I believe that they're even actually chordates. Which... No, I don't think sponges are chordates. Hang on, I gotta look this up now. I do not want to misclassify people. Sponge phylogeny. Now just take me all the way up to the top. I need to see, like, a tree. I don't think they are. Tunicates are chordates. And tunicates look kind of like sponges. Okay, yeah, it's not the sponge, it's a tunicate. Tunicates look kind of like sponges. The only reason I say that is because chordates are actually... they're still invertebrates, but they have the beginnings. At some point in their development, they actually have the beginnings of what eventually became the spinal cord.
I can find a voice recording here.
Huh? Oh. Oh, green shine.
Yeah, I can trade this green shine.
I think I have to go up from the other side. Around this way, I think. Whoa. Ah. There we go. Cool.
hope that life could survive.
It's actually kind of sad. I have like 14 skill points to use, so that's not what I wanted to do. We'll equip that one. Okay, so I've got Machine Master, Infiltrator, and Hunter fully filled up. Let's do Warrior next, I guess. Oh, I like that. Well, that looks fun. There we go. Okay. Penguin. I'm level 48 now, by the way, in case anybody's curious. Okay, and then there's a question mark up here, so we'll go check that out.
From the old world. The building doesn't look like any of the ruins around here. Maybe it's underwater now.
There's the San Francisco Bridge. No, I want this pelican. Damn you, I am getting a picture of a pelican. I'm looking for something that looks kind of like a big dome. Oh, right there. There we go. There's another one here? Okay. Let's go there then and see what's there. I wanted to see this though. Oh, wait, no, it'll be under. Collectibles. Welcome to the Grand Gate stop of our VistaPoint tour, brought to you by Miriam Technologies and the Coalition for Environmental Reclamation. The Grand Gate Bridge, its span acts as a gateway to San Francisco, while the water below is a conduit to the Pacific Ocean, which by 2040 had reached critical levels of human-made contaminants. The clawback era saw massive reductions to seaborne plastic pollution, and Miriam Technologies is proud to continue that trend. In fact, the new roadway atop the bridge was made with repurposed petroleum-based waste products, dredged from the ocean waters by our machines. Miriam Technologies deserves our thanks. Never thought I would get to see the Grand Gate. My journey is almost over. Only one more stop and one more note to leave behind. Kind of want a drone drop from the top of the bridge. Ride down would be swank. Glad I don't have to swim around and eat plastic all day. That would data corrupt. The funny thing is, and the kind of cool thing is that some places, some companies are already making plastic products from ocean water microplastic dredge. I believe Razor is actually one of them. I think Microsoft has a mouse as well. I think. Hey, Tooch. Tooch, look at this underwater stuff. Like, shit's insane. Mux was mentioning yesterday how games are starting to do underwater really well. How are you doing though, Tooch? December 22nd, 2059. The daring midnight rescue of teen heiress Sonali Jiva from the hands of labor extremists might sound like something from an action holo, but Eric Visser, First Imperator CEO... Oh my god! That's why they called him the CEO! It was a misinterpretation of CEO! I'm sorry. I just clicked! Because I figured the whole time it sounded more like a title than a name. That's why they called him CEO. Oh my god. I didn't even click until I saw it on, like, in writing. Oh, it's quick to assure us that the reports of this human-led raid are completely true. Our employment of specialized human operators is what makes First Imperator stand out. Sure, a team of hunter-killer killer bots could have eliminated all those activists like we did, but could they have gotten the girl out unharmed? I don't think so. Dressed in night fatigues, Eric's rugged looks sell confidence as he goes on to explore what sets his operation above the rest. Technology plays its part, but true combat is about courage, adrenaline, and hot blood. In those situations, it's the man, not the weapon, that data corrupt. Good, ready for exploring what looks to be one of the biggest slash compact zones that FromSoft has ever made. It looks so big, nice. Man. That looks so fucking cool. That actually looks pretty cool too. Let's do some different versions of this. I feel like on the underwater ones, you at least have to do vibrant.
Shake off this wet.
Oh, that looked like a safe that I could go into. But no. Is there... Okay, there's something right here. We'll grab that, and then we'll go get the... We will kill that. Eventually. Should I try it, guys? Okay, guys, it's up to you. Should I try killing this thing? It's level 45 and I am level 48. I feel like we should wait a bit. You looked away for a second, didn't realize I was in photo mode until you looked at it closer. Fuck it. That music. Crap, I missed catching that one though. Thank you. Oh god, it found me! Does this affect... I don't think this affects...
Mind if I borrow that weapon?
Oh. We're doing it! It's slow going, but we're doing it. Crap, I missed. Power shots. Yes! Go, go, go! Yes! I got him! We did not do a strategic kill on that. I don't know if I broke off anything that gets me anything special. Aside from getting to use a few of his weapons. But we killed him, and that's the important thing. Heck yeah! Well, I did break off something good. Oh no, that was a pelican. A pelican got caught in the crossfire. That That was fucking awesome. That was actually pretty damn awesome.